Hi everybody, it's Shalene, and I am doing the color along for Laura's Color Along, which is Anxiety Art Adventures YouTube channel, and she has a Facebook group, and I am still working on the Dragons book. I have this much done of it. And today I'm going to work on the angel. I have my cup of water that's got frozen fruit in it instead of ice cubes. And I think that I've got the hiccups now all of a sudden. Sorry. If you hear any noise, it might be the dryer. I have laundry going. It's not in the same room as I'm in, but you might still hear it. And I have the animals wandering around, as usual. Scott is sleeping, and Justin is out with a friend because he was on vacation this week. So I decided to do the angel's dress in a purple color. And this is Lilac Prismacolor pencils. And I outlined with a Stabilo fine liner. I hope that you've all had a good week. Mine's been okay. I've been a little better. We did take Dylan out for dinner Saturday night, but I think I already talked about this in the last video. And Monday I took Justin out for sushi for his birthday. We don't usually buy gifts, we just take them out for dinner. So, anyways, the last time I was in the city, I had seen a restaurant that said all you can eat sushi. It used to be an Irish bar. So I told Justin, let's go. So he looked it up online. And it told their hours and it said it was open. And so I was going to pull down the side road because it's right on the corner of a main road and a side road. And there, it was dark in there and not a car in sight. But on their website, it says they were open. It did not say that they closed. It didn't say opening soon. It didn't say anything like that. So we have no idea what was going on with that place. But I ended up pulling into the mall parking lot and parked in a parking spot and looked up another place to go to for sushi, and that was right up the road. So we ended up going there, and they had all you can eat sushi, and it included an appetizer, which you got to choose the appetizer. And it included salad and miso soup. And then all you can eat of the sushi and dessert. Well, they bring you out your appetizer. So we ate our appetizer, and we ended up both getting crab rangoons because we really like those. And then we waited a little bit. They brought out our salad and our soup, and we waited a little bit, and there was only people at two other tables, and I was the only female in there. They were all guys. It's really weird. And then they brought us out a plate that had two large sushi rolls on it. Well, by the time I got done with those two rolls, I couldn't eat another bite. So I told her I didn't want any more. Justin ended up, after the first plate, they only bring you out one sushi roll at a time. And you don't get to pick what sushi you want. It's chef's choice. So you have no idea what you're going to get. But the second plate only had one large roll on it. And Justin got full on that one. And we didn't even get dessert because we didn't have room for it. And we've been to other places where it's all you can eat sushi, and they bring it to your table. It's never included salad and soup and an appetizer. It's just sushi. It was very good. They have very good reviews online. So I'm glad we went. But I still don't know what happened with that other place. There was no sign on the door saying that it was closed. There was nothing. And then we came home. I was surprised Justin had me drive because he gets car sick in my car for some reason. He says he feels claustrophobic in it. I have a little two-door Scion TC. I absolutely love this car. It's paid off. It got paid off last summer. It's been a really good car. I did test drive a 6-speed. When did I do that? In 3 years ago? But they didn't want to give me much for my car, so I said, never mind. I felt my car was worth a little bit more than what they were asking for. And they're the kind of car dealer, I don't know what it is with car dealerships now, but they don't like to budge. And so most of them now, I don't know about where any of you live, but the new motto is the sticker price is what you get. There's no negotiations. And it's like that everywhere's around here now. And so I tried negotiating and they kept telling me, no, we don't do that. The price you see is what you get. Okay. And it's the same car dealership where I went and got the car I already have. Can you see what I'm doing? And now I can't get another car anyways because I can't prove I have a job. So if I was to get a car, it would have to go under Scott's name. And until I pay off a few bills, I can't afford a car payment right now anyways. Oh, and this color is, I never know how to pronounce it. Is it Dahlia or Dahlia purple? Dahlia? Dahlia? I never know how to pronounce it. So that's the deep purple that I'm using right now. I did get a color. I got two coloring books. I got one Sunday from Amazon and yesterday. So I'll show them Saturday. Because you never know if I shop and get anything else this week. So I'll wait and see what's going on. My mom and my sister do the Young Living essential oils. And so Sunday, my sister did a show at my mom's house, so I'm going to be buying the starter kit. They're all natural. My sister said she was not a believer till she started using the products. She thought it was a bunch of malarkey. So my mom had given me some peppermint oil couple weeks ago, and I've used that when I've had headaches instead of taking ibuprofen, and it actually worked. There was only one time I used it and it didn't touch the headache, but I've used it a couple other times and it was fine. I don't get headaches much. I get small ones, and I'm not the type to take ibuprofen unless it gets to the point where I'm sick to my stomach, and then I'll take the ibuprofen. T- I never ever take my coloring when I go and babysit. And I thought, you know what? I get there at 6:15. Blake doesn't usually wake up till 9. Carson doesn't usually wake up till 10. Why am I not taking my coloring? I sit there and I use my laptop to watch YouTube videos. And if someone's on Ustream, I'll watch them. So I decide I'll take this with me. Now when I color here at home, I'm either at my kitchen table like I am now, or I have a table mate set up in my family room. But my son's kitchen chairs are very uncomfortable and they cut off the circulation in my legs. So I didn't want to sit at the table. Sometimes I'll take one of their pillows off the couch and I'll set it on the chair. But I thought I'll just sit on the couch. I'll be fine. I don't think that's a piece of her hair. I think that's her collar. Maybe it is a piece of her hair. So I start watching videos and I start coloring, and all I brought with me was the two greens and the green liner, outliner, so I could work on the dragon. So I brought the two pencils, the fine liner, this eraser with the little brush, and this little pencil sharpener. And I sit on their sectional and I'm coloring. I sharpened the pencils and I didn't have to sharpen them again. They're good. The sharpener was sitting next to me. And all of a sudden it falls down in between the sectionals. Like, great. I can't get my arm down in there. I can't pull the sectional apart. So I decide I'll text Scott. So I text him. When you're on your way home from town, will you please stop here? I need help. So he says, I will be there in 10 to 15 minutes. And I said, no, I'm not in a hurry. I'm fine. And he said, are you sure? And I said, yes, it's not an emergency. He says, oh, I thought maybe the boys were playing Houdini and had you tied up. Dropped my pencil sharpener in the sectional and I can't get the sectional apart. Says okay, so he shows up. He can't see in between the cushions of the sectional and says, oh, is there a flashlight? And I said, I don't know. I don't know where Dylan keeps them. Probably in his truck at work. So Scott goes out to his truck and comes back with his flashlight. Finally gets my pencil sharpener, turns around and tells me it's $16 a minute that he charged me. Yeah, right. You're funny. I said, well, if I'd have known that, I would have just left it there and waited for them to come home because I didn't need it. And I have three more of these pencil sharpeners at home. He's too funny. $16 a minute. Yeah. I would have, could have just waited for Carson to come home and stuck his little fingers down in there and reached it. Then he was on his way. So I colored the dragon. That's all I wanted to do at their house. So I was happy with what I got done. Wow, that dress looks pretty. Okay. I think the angel's wings need to be what, a grayish white, not silver, a light gray. What do I have for grays? A warm gray. And another warm gray. That should work. Or is that too dark? Should I try? Okay, a cool gray. About those two. Okay, I don't know if I have a gray. I probably have to use, oh, I do have a gray. A gray Stabilo, a 50% cool gray, and a 30% warm gray. So let's work on these wings. Last night I had dinner with Dylan, Amber, and the boys. And Justin was there too. Usually when I eat dinner at their place, I get tacos. Which is fine because I like tacos. But we ended up having barbecue chicken that Dylan did out on the grill. And mashed potatoes and green beans that Dylan did because Amber doesn't cook. I did buy her a crock pot a couple Christmases ago, but she hardly uses it, and then Dylan said she broke the handle of the top. It's still usable, but they don't use it. She can bake, she just doesn't know how to cook. So Dylan always cooks. He has sent me pictures from their house of her doing like fish sticks and stuff in the oven, and she burns those, so yeah, she doesn't cook. I have a feeling when I go over this, I should use the white pencil. Maybe. Just because they're wings. Kind of blend it a little bit with the white. So how many of you are doing this color along with Laura? I'm not going to get as many pages done with Laura's color along as I did with Jen's. With Jen's, I got 3 pages done. But I think because I'm a little intimidated by the grayscale. And I'm taking my time more with this grayscale. I don't know if any of you saw Jess's owls she did. Jess's Coloring Corner, I believe, is her Facebook group. Her YouTube channel is Jessica Robertson. She did 2 spreads, 2 pages with owls on it. One of Kirby Rosanis's Morphia books. I can't remember which one. It's gorgeous. And she showed her coloring them on YouTube. My birthday is Sunday, so I have no idea what's going on this weekend for that. I would like the 150 or 120, whatever the set is, of the Faber Castell Polychromos, but Scott said that the essential oils that I wanted is what I get. So we'll see. Sometimes he changes his mind. You still see it? And now I see that sunlight is going across. I have the blinds turned facing up so that I wouldn't get all that glare, but that's still not working. So there's still quite a few color alongs going on. Right now it's Laura from Anxiety Art Adventures, which I already mentioned. And then I can't remember if mine is next or Jessica's is next. And then one of ours is after that, and then Sharon is can't remember her channel. I know it's Sweet Nightingale, but I can't remember. What the numbers are after it. And then her coloring group for the color lawn is Color with Sharon and Friends. Huh. Okay, the wings are done. How much time do I have left? I can't even read my camera. It's only been 31 minutes. I did that much in 31 minutes. Wow. Okay. I told you I colored fast. Now, should I do her hair blonde? I don't even know how to do that. If I have, wow, don't want it to. How about this? And maybe we'll see how well this goes. I'm not guaranteeing anything, and I think I will use this Stabello, and I've got Spanish Orange and Jasmine. Think they'll be okay? Hope so. Oh well, if not, it's mine. And that light is hitting this there. So what has everybody been up to this week? Any coloring? This is the only coloring I've gotten in so far. I really need to find a different setup for watching TV and or watching videos. Has anybody been getting any bad weather? We've had weird weather. It's been cool and then it gets warm. Then it'll cool down for a few days. Then it'll warm up for a few days. A up. I'm happy with her hair. I know, I color fast. I just pick something and I just go for it. Okay, skin tone. Got peach, rosy beige, beige sienna. What do we got? Beige. I want pink. Peach beige. Light peach. Deco peach. Deco pink. Let's try the light peach. With the peach. And what's this? This, I guess, for outlining, which isn't much outlining because I did most of it. Had anything else going on? I have been reading. I'm on the 10th book out of 13 of the Women of the Otherworld series by Kelly Armstrong. And I'm enjoying that. I want a light pink. So, I would really like to finish this series. I wanted it all done at the end of this month, but I have been in kind of a reading slump, and I've been coloring, and I'm coloring and I'm watching too many videos, so nothing's getting done. Watching too many videos, spending too much time on the computer, and I'm gonna have to change that because I am missing out on TV shows. Tuesday night was the series finale of Bones, and I'm behind on that show. That was on at the same time as This Is Us. Say DVR'd Bones. And now I'm just gonna sit and binge watch it. I guess that's her arm there, the sleeve rolled up. I don't think that was the sleeve there. So I have that. I'm behind on Supernatural. I still have to finish Shadowhunters. I'm still on the first season. I still have to read the book The Magicians so I can watch that show that I've been DVRing. I have a ton of movies. Try to watch most of the videos at Dylan's house because I have my internet is with a satellite company that's very expensive. Sorry, I had to get something to drink. It's very expensive. And it's not unlimited data. You have so much data you can use between 8 a.m. and 2 a.m. and then the rest of the data between 2 a.m. and 8 a.m. So I try. Stupid lights. Gonna try the at light again. So I try to watch most of the videos in the morning while the boys are still sleeping, and then once they're up, that's usually like if somebody's streaming. How's that? Okay. If somebody's doing a Ustream live, then I'll go on and watch that while the boys are having breakfast and playing in the morning. This is purple and it looks blue in the viewfinder. Oh well. Looks like she's got a flower in her hand. We're going to make that pink. So I used pink and we'll use neon pink. Just give it a little pop of color. How does that look? Okay. Just a little pop of color. There. And bit of green. You really can't see it, the stems here, but I'm not going to outline or anything. I'm just doing a little bit of green there. So that's it for internet. High speed internet stops like a mile up the road both ends, and there's 20 houses in between, and we've all asked cable company, because we have satellite TVs too, because the cable company won't come down for TV. We have been asking for many, many, many years, and we each one of us neighbors get told, each one of us, mind you, not just all of us combined, that they'll put it in if we give them $30,000. Well, for $30 freaking, they had better give me free internet for the rest of my life. I'll tell you that, no matter where I live. Freaking idiots. And then I call my phone company because I have a landline, because we have bad reception for cell phones. It's great for texting and stuff, but phone calls get dropped all the time. So I have a landline. So I asked the phone company if we could get their internet. Well, no, because then they'd have to put in all new lines. Then put in new lines. They're all, they need to put in the new fiber optic lines. Well, why aren't they up now? This is the year 2017 and we still don't have the optic lines like everybody else around the neighborhood does. Unreal. So I have been calling the phone company since 2007. It's 10 years. And every time I call, I get told they're doing it next month. They're doing it next month. Keep calling, keep calling. So for the first few months, I kept talking to the same guy. And he says, every time you call here, I make a notation you've called. Just ask for me. Well, then it got to the point where he wasn't taking my phone calls. I ended up talking to other people. The last time I called was, I don't think I called last year. Was the year before, because we keep getting told next year now. Next year, next year. You'll have it by 2010. Uh-huh. We still don't have it. Anyways, the last time I called, I had a really rude guy tell me that I'm out in the country, I'm lucky I have a phone line at all, and he laughed at me. And so I had a few choice words for him, and I hung up on him. And I haven't called them back. You'd think that they'd want business because a lot of people do not have landlines anymore because of the cell phones. So you'd think they'd be a little bit nicer. Nope. Not at all. Not very happy with Frontier to sit there and tell me that. That was really rude. And I had, who do I have now? I have HughesNet for internet. I used to have Wild Blue. So Wild Blue used to give you so much data a month, and then at the beginning of the cycle, it would start over again. Well, they ended up changing it where it doesn't start over again. You just keep going on. So if you use up all your data, like say, I don't even know how to describe it. It just keeps going every day. So you need to like use less every day so that it keeps it at a certain speed. And if you go over that, then you gotta wait a few days till you can use the internet again. Like screw that. So I've checked into HughesNet and I called them. And they said, that's ridiculous. It starts over again. So the 19th of every month, it starts over again at 100%. And then they have a meter, so you can check it every day. to see where you're at, how much you've used already. Which I really like. And it only goes out when it's storming really, really bad, and it doesn't stay out long. When I had Wild Blue, it was out all the time. And it would stay out for a day or two. And then I would call them. I didn't get to use it. I shouldn't have to lose any of my data. They were jerks. Has to be out for at least 2 weeks for them to do anything. Okay, well, guess what? I don't have them anymore. So, I do love living out in the country. It just has its drawbacks. Pros and cons. It used to be very noisy here because I had neighbors with stupid hunting dogs. And they would bay all night long. And they moved, thank God. So I used to have to sleep with a fan on all the time, every night, no matter what season it was. I complained to them. They said, well, they're hunting dogs. All the neighbors complained to them. They didn't care. They said, we don't hear them. So they've moved a few months ago, and this is the first time in several years that I can hear the peepers outside at night. I'm loving it. So I'm hoping this summer I will be able to hear the owl that we used to be able to hear. I don't even know how to do this part of this. I can't tell what's water. Is this all supposed to be water? I guess I'm going to have to go look online, see if someone colored some of this. And I have a is it called Posco pen? I think I'll add some ripples in the water. So I think I'm gonna color all night. I do have a couple videos to watch. Some are BookTube videos. And I think I'll watch Bones. Though I didn't watch last week's Grey's Anatomy. And I didn't watch Sunday's Once Upon a Time, so I could watch those instead. Then I'll be caught up for tomorrow's Grays and Sunday night's show. So that's what I have done. Sorry you didn't see the water. So that's what I did, and I think I'm going to get some that, is it Posco White pen and put some white in there. And it's an angel. I really don't want to put any glitter, but I might do just a little bit in the wings. And I still have to do the dragon's eyes and their horns. Then I'm going to have to look at some pictures to see if it's water with like lily pads in them. I'm not sure. But that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you liked this video, please click on the like button. And if you would like to see more, please click on subscribe. And next to the subscribe button is a little bell, and that's the notification. And if you click on that, that will notify you through your email whenever I put up a new video. And I have to tell you, my subscribers are flying. It's just unreal. I appreciate all of you. I will be getting up a reading video this week sometime because I have not done one, I think, in over a month. And I really, really need to do that for my BookTube people. And then, if I don't have plans on Sunday, I am hoping to do a cross-stitch video. So look out for that. And that's it for today. I will see you all later. Have a good day. Bye.